there's always a lot of discussion and camaraderie and I guess curiosity of what actually goes into a strength and conditioning program, and I'd like to start with just the strength side of it. Can you give me what your definition of the goals and the benefits of strength training are when you go and sit down in the coach's meeting? How do you just, you know, describe what your program is and your approach is?
No, I don't know if it's, you know, my program. I think there's certain basic physiological principles with regard to, you know, progressive resistance exercise. And I think when you sit down with an individual, you know, first and foremost, you want to find out, you know, what their injury history is. Because really the primary role of the strength training program is to, you know, prevent injuries and to make sure that the athlete, you know, gains enough strength and muscular balance so you can help minimize. You know, injuries are always a part of any game. You want to help maybe minimize those, or if they do get injured, expedite the rehabilitative process. For instance, if I see a lot of high school athletes, usually, you know, they've neglected the posterior part of their body. You know, a lot of athletes will train what they see in the mirror. So it's what I have to do is make sure that, you know, boy, you know, we're strong, you know, in the back as well as the front. We're strong right to left. And if they're in a collision sport, I got to make sure they're protected, you know, protecting that head, the neck. And if we're trying to, you know, get a little bit, you want to make sure we improve the body composition of an athlete. So getting somebody stronger is not that hard. And I think you have to have the proper, you know, intensity of work that's done. You have to have a systematic approach for progression that's, you know, built into the program, and making sure that there's, you know, adequate rest in between training sessions. And so, I mean, I've trained guys for, you know, MVP of the NFL, and I've trained guys that were, you know, high school players, and that's, you know, probably the only, you know, they didn't go beyond that level. And, you know, how the muscles respond and adapt to exercise is not that complex. You know, obviously some individuals have some genetic gifts that afford them the opportunity to perhaps adapt a little bit better than most people.